So at this point, we are minutes away from the wedding, and I'm in my bridal suite, and I'm just by myself, I'm alone, and I'm just kind of having a moment of silence, a moment of calm before walking down the aisle.
And then it just went to hell.
Landon's sister and his four-year-old niece, who's my flower girl, bust in the door, completely covered in diarrhea.
Yeah.
She had a major explosion in the car.
Oh my God.
It was everywhere. It was inside the car. It was all over her. I mean, it was literally everywhere.
So I'm long ready, just standing up there, you know, waiting for her to walk down the aisle, listening to the music, smiling, nodding at the people.
So we grab some baby wipes, and we are frantically trying to wipe it down.
Don't worry, she'll be here.
I'm just wondering what the holdup is at this point.
Like minutes from me walking down the aisle, I'm thinking, what are we gonna do?
They're having to replay some songs. Is she getting cold feet? Is she nauseous? I didn't know what was going on. I thought I was just gonna have a wedding and a nice day.
You did. You thought everything was just going right behind the scenes.
Yeah.
There's like a.
You're already just like. Oh.
There's a code brown happening behind the scenes, and he has no idea. There is no time to get the stains completely out. I am ready for the most important walk of my life. And I pray to the wedding gods that this will be the worst thing that happens today. I look over at Alyssa, the flower girl, and she's just beaming, smiling. Kids are very resilient. You know, they always bounce back so quickly.
I now pronounce you man and wife.
So we're thinking the wedding is done. We're ready to party. We're ready to sit down, relax.
And party! Just,
yeah, and have a good time. So about halfway through the reception, we start to notice how quiet and calm things are getting. It's starting to feel a little bit more like a wake than a wedding. I'm getting a little worried at this point. Well, everybody's starting to look a little clammy, sweaty, but it's not from the heat.
People kind of looking more pale.
So it sounded like everyone in the room was turning into something.
Our fairy tale wedding turned out not to be so fairy tale.
Turned into a horror story.
People were holding their stomachs, you know, holding their mouths, moaning, and just, ugh, bad. And I'm starting to feel really concerned because I don't know what's going on. And then all hell broke loose. What happened next was like the worst thing that could happen to a bride and groom at a wedding. One of our guests gets up. He's running towards us. And at the last second, he makes a beeline for the restroom. And then I look back at everyone else and I knew this is not gonna end well. There was like this mass exodus from the reception hall to the bathrooms. Like 20, 30
yes,
people getting up at one time to run to the restroom.
People are vomiting, people are, running to the toilet. I mean, it was just crazy.
Everybody's lining up, we're getting worried, and we're starting to believe that we will not be able to accommodate everyone's toilet needs.
Because there was only 3 bathrooms there. How are all these people getting so sick?
We tore that restroom. I mean, we... Sorry, Father, for we have sinned in your restroom.
People are refusing to give up their stalls, telling others to improvise ways to relieve themselves, so they're grabbing, you know, bags, trash cans, sinks.
It was ugly. I personally went to get a mop to clean it up, but when I walked in the janitor's room, you couldn't use that bucket anymore.
So then literally people start running outside because there's no other place to go.
In that moment, I felt like it was my fault. We ate a buffet before, and then it was a buffet-style wedding.
We're thinking it could be food poisoning or something of that nature.
And at that point, we see some of our vegan friends actually start to get up and use the restroom. They actually didn't eat any of the food at all, because most things, you know, have the meat and cheese.
Yeah. They were just like, where's that food?
I'm thinking it's not the food at all. So as everything is kind of going south, you know, we're trying to think about
what's going on.
What is going on?
What
is causing this? Yeah.
Someone eventually calls 911. They ask how many ambulances they need, and I tell them it's 130 people.
So while we were actually in the emergency room, a doctor came up to us and told us that, like, for this sort of thing to happen, exposure had to have occurred 15 to 20 hours prior to the outbreak. And he thinks that everybody had contracted a highly contagious stomach virus.
She had a major explosion in the car.
So then at that point, you know, that's when my mind goes back to, you know, our flower girl, Alyssa, and she was the first one that was totally covered in puke and poop.
Cheers.
We had the rehearsal dinner on Friday. After dinner was finished, I stood up and kind of gave a toast, just thanking everybody for coming and kind of a shout out to our flower girls, in which then, you know, they got excited and stood up and, you know, they were went around hugging and kissing everybody.
Now we realize that the night of the rehearsal dinner, Alyssa was contaminating everyone then, her and the other flower girl.
She even accidentally sneezed in my mouth.
So we find out that a week before the wedding, our niece was diagnosed with norovirus.
Norovirus is a really contagious virus that's easily transmitted from person to person. Because it's so easily transmissible, it can take out even hundreds of people at the same time.
2 days prior to the wedding, her pediatrician had signed her off like a clean bill of health, saying that she was completely fine and did not have the norovirus anymore. Well, he was dead wrong.
So who could have known that this beautiful, sweet, dimply blue-eyed, beautiful little girl with her flowers could almost kill everybody? We literally nicknamed her Typhoid Mary for years. We still call her that sometimes.
When I found out it was because of me, I kind of freaked out, kind of, but not really. I mean, I feel bad. It was not a good day.